Hi, this is Aishik from MATLAB Helper. Welcome to our tutorial on how to extract data from Excel with the help of MATLAB. Stay tuned for further process. Let us discuss what is a data. Data characteristics or information usually numerical that are collected through observation. In a more technical sense, data is a set of values of qualitative or quantitative variables about one or more objects. That may be a analysis from engineering or from lab experiment, maybe population count or anything around the world. So let us take an example of a database Excel where all the data around the world, for example world population or lab experience, maybe engineering analysis or IT information, are stored in a particular database. Now the question is, we have the database, but how to use it effectively to plot any chart, any sales chart or any bar graph to predict the future? And that is what I am going to teach you in this particular video, how to extract data from an Excel sheet with the help of MATLAB to plot different plots and extract other crucial information from the boring spreadsheet. So our task in this video is to extract data of COVID-19 statistics and plotting, as well as sales statistics of an imaginary region and determining the most valuable brand. So let us start. Peak distribution worldwide, and we have to import this Excel sheet in MATLAB. So let us open this Excel sheet first. Okay, so this is our Excel sheet. All the everything from columns and headings are imported as usual. And after that, what we have to do, we have to import that table in our MATLAB. So in that right hand, but top right hand, we can see there is one import option, import selection, and you have to click at this drop down, and here we get three options, that is import data. If we import data, the whole code, the whole data will be stored as a table. If we generate a script, it will only generate a script. If we generate a function, it will generate a function which can be called through other scripts. So let us do a generate function. And here is our generated function, and whatever codes are written here are already inbuilt. We have to modify these codes, these scripts, as we require. This is the name of the function, and these are the input arguments that you need to provide to the function. And just notice that the name of our function and the name of the script is similar. This is the output of the function. And next, now the variable that we have removed from this argument, we have to define somewhere inside this function. So start row will be equals to 2, and the end row will be equals to 13,419, which is the end row of the COVID-19 geographical distribution worldwide Excel sheet. So the next is defining the output file. The name should be as it is, like the Excel sheet, and the sheet name should be the sheet name of the same. Now in this particular block, the data is being imported, extracted using spreadsheet function. So in this particular code, they are going to do Excel sheet of that workflow file and the sheet name that we have provided in this particular block. And printf is for taking the input of the start row and the end row value that we have put. There is nothing too much you can do with this data that is already inbuilt. So next, with this command, a table is being created having the name table out, and this particular table out different variables like day, month, year, cases, dates, countries and territories, GOID, and everything is being stored one by one. Our main script where we are going to call the function and further do all the processing. So CLC clear on and close all, as usual, is used for clear any other output in the command window. To clear all is used to clear any other variable, and close is used to close any other plotting or whatever data is being opened. Now with this command we are calling the function, and in this particular readtable table our XLS file will be stored. Now in the countries variable, what we are going to do, we are going to store all the countries that is defined in the Excel sheet. So let me open the Excel sheet to give a proper reference. So this is our Excel sheet, and as you can see, countries are territories, which is countries and territories where all the name of the countries has been depicted. In this particular column, countries and territories, all the name of the countries have been stored, and as you can see, the type is categorical. So in this function, next what we want, the particular name of individual country. So for that, what we are going to do, we are going to use the categories command to get every unique country that is within the sheet. So just let me run this sheet for one time. If we see only the countries and unique countries, so you can see in countries we are going to have everything that is being stored in the particular countries and territories. So maybe 100 times Afghanistan, then 50 times Armenia, like that. But we need like unique countries about which the data is being given. So in the unique countries we'll get like Afghanistan, Albania, Algeria, Andorra, Angola, Angolia, Antigua, and something Argentina, Armenia, like that. So next, what we want is the use of for loop to segregate the cases and dates. For that, we are going to use a for loop from I is equals to 1 to number of countries, which from I is equals to 1 is to number of countries, and in a particular data specific country variable we are going to store each and every country that is matching with our sheet. Like in unique countries 1, I when the value of I will be 1, it will be Afghanistan, and it will be matched with each and every country that will be there in the countries table. And whatever the match will be, that particular row with all the columns will be stored in data specific country. Now next, in the data cases we are storing all the case that is being happened in that particular country, and the similar way we are storing the days that has happened in that particular country, and data underscore dates. Now notice these both array are cell arrays, and in the data dot date we are storing the unique date of the particular country that is the of which the data is given. And the next one is plotting the data. We are giving a coordinate. Next we are plotting the data, and subplot is 212, another coordinate, and now we are plotting data versus dates. Now here we are plotting for only two country. First one is Afghanistan, next one is next country. So for both you are plotting date versus cases and date versus deaths, and date versus cases versus and date. Okay, so our next task is to process this particular data, which is named as sample data, and we have these headings as order date, region, rep, item, units, unit cost, and total. So basically what it is, these are a sales calendar of different region for east, central, or west, and a particular item that belongs to a particular brand, and which is sold in how much amount, and what is the total cost corresponding to a unit cost. So our task in this particular script will be to judge in each region which company has the most order. So this is the imported Excel sheet on how I have done it. I have already explained in the previous section. So what we are going to do, we are going to rename this file as sales order, which I have already done, and we are going to put the arguments in this format. Workbook file is equal to sample data dot xlx, sheet name is equal to sales order, and start row is equal to 2, and end row is basically 43. So you can check that from here we are going to start, and we are going to end right at this here. So next this all the data, we are not going to touch anything, and here is our table out. So moving on to the next section, where we are going to basically process this data and try to extract some information. First of all, the same basic things, and order is equal to sales order. So in order, we are going to get the table which is defined in sample order, and in again we are going to store the individual's region in order one, correct? And next, our next target is to matching the index of individual element with order one with the region in order. So with this particular code, what are we going to get? We are going to get the brand, the individual brand that is present in all region. And the down one, this particular code, what we are going to do, this case one, case two, case two are making for each region. Like case one is for central, case two is for east, and case three is for west. Therefore, by putting this command, putting this script, what we are getting, that in every zone or in every region, for example central region, how much order is belong to which company element wise. In the downer, we are going to convert that particular brand into matrix, and we are going to sort it, and we will get the maximum value. So let me run it and then analyze how it is basically working. So you can see most valuable company in central region is Keval, most valuable is Parent, in east is Parent, and most valuable in west is Sorvino. Now let us go one by one. So first of all, we are going to see what is stored in order. So we will come down and order. So the whole table you are actually getting in the order, comprising of each and every data. Next, we are going to see what is categories in order.region. So you can see order.region basically contains this whole column, and we are going to use categories function to get the unique region. So let's see what is there in order one. It should contain only three elements, as west, south and east. Oh, sorry, west, central and east. Okay, central, east and west as usual. Now next, we are taking the length of order one, that is three, and we are storing order underscore zone, and actually we are matching that particular order one, that means east with order region, west with order region, and central with order region, so that the order zone has the all the data in three different columns. So let's see what is there in order zone. So 23 into 7, 13 into 7, 16 into 7, that means in central we have this much of data, everything comes in central. Next one will be your east, so this much data with company and order as well as cost is given, and last one is as usual our west, and this much only order is there. So let us close all this. Next we are going to get the individual brand. Okay, so order underscore zone I, that means in each zone there is certain companies, right? In east there is Parent, again east there is Zone, central is Gill, central it is Smith. So we want to get the data that in each zone how many companies are present individually. So let's see what is there in brand for us. This is for central, this is for east, this is for west. So Andrews, Gill, Howard, Jardine, Jones, Keval, Morgan, Parent, Smith, Sorvino, Thompson. Okay, these are the companies who sells product in this particular region. Now next is little critical. We are going to take the size of order zone which we got from there, and we are going to make a for loop, basically well two for loop, and this switch case is used to store three region orders individually. So what actually we are doing over there is brand that is stored in the name of the company that is stored in the brand will be matched, and that particular index whatever value is will be stored in central order. So if you go to central order and see, basically these are the different brands. You can see there are 11 brands, right? So first one will be your Andrews. So Andrews has this much sale in central. Second one will be our gill. So gill has this much cell in central. The third, fourth one, or you can say third one because this component is not present in that particular region. So we have a giardia has this much cell in central. So these data we are actually storing brand wise, that which brand has sold how many, how much data, elements or products in a particular region. Same if we see east order, we can see that Harvard has only two cell, one is binder and in paid in 29 units and 96 units. So total they have sold this much amount of money, they have gained this much amount of money. Same we can see for this one, like Jones, they have this much elements sold in their, in that particular region. And you can ask me that why these are given as empty. Basically this company which is in brand is has not able to or has not sold anything in that particular region. For example, Andrews. So this one is empty. That means Andrews company hasn't sold anything in that, in the east region. So you can basically verify if we go to east and okay, there you cannot see any Andrews. Correct? So that's how this thing works. So now the same way you can also verify the west region. And later let me come to this brand item. What is basically what it will do, it will calculate the sum of each company in each particular region. So let's see what is in brand item underscore C. So the Andrews has sold this much amount, the next company has sold this much amount, the fourth one this much, sixth one this much, seventh one this much, ninth one this much. So in every index is corresponds to every company, and we will get that which company has got the biggest sale by comparing these values using sort command. Same one in E, this is the component that have sold, that has this much sold, these are all in dollars. So next one we are going to convert this brand item underscore key, that means that particular cell value, in matrix format, so that we can process. And we're going to sort these particular elements in ascending order. And next what we're going to do, we're going to print the most valuable company in central region by taking this central, and we're going to match this with the max end. So max end will give us the maximum value, and by comparing this we'll get that which company had sold that maximum amount. So that particular index we are going to put it over in the central order, and we'll get that value, that is as given. The same way we are doing for east and we are doing for west. And now for verification, for example you want to do a verification that is really sent in central keyval has the biggest cell or something like that, you can do it easily. You can go, what you have to do, you have to go to this Excel sheet, you have to put central, and you're going to put it as keyval. And there's basically more. So if you try to calculate this one and compare it with the other companies, like for example Andrews or something, so you'll get that keyval has the maximum sale. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found this helpful. If you have any query, post it in the comment section or get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.